prove the night in and night out that they're playing the best basketball or the best team. What's interesting to me is how other teams, what philosophy other teams are going to use when they go against Baylor. You're either going to try to take away Brittany Griner or you're going to try to take away Addison Sims. And which one of those defensive philosophies is going to be more effective? You're going to give up the three or give up a two. And when you look at just their last game against Tennessee, and Tennessee focusing a lot of effort to surround Brittany Griner inside, and then Odyssey Sims and the Baylor backcourt goes off and has 8 of 15 three-point shots. And so what will the philosophy be for Stanford in this game? Will they try to take away the head of the monster, or will they try to take away the rest of the monster? And that is interesting to me. What is also interesting to me is what teams will do offensively when they're going against Baylor. What will they do to make Brittany Griner a little less comfortable in her positioning? Are they going to try to draw her out with pick and rolls? Are they going to try to find a way to get Brittany Griner out of the lane where she blocks shots, halters shots, makes teams take a very difficult shot? So it's just the chess match part of this matchup is interesting to me, both on the defensive and offensive end, because Baylor right now, they're tough to deal with when you've got one of the best point guards in the country, one of the best player in the country, and then Destiny Williams, a fantastic complementary player. I mean, when you look at the fact that she led the Big 12 in rebounding during the Big 12 season, and Brittany Griner on her team, which is a pretty impressive number. So.